प्रॉब्लम इन ओके दिस इज दैट अंडरस्टूड आई सपोज नो नाउ वी आर डूइंग नाउ 53 ओके आई सी द क्वेश्चन एंड सॉल्व द इक्वेशन रेस्ट यू हैव टू डू योरसेल्फ Question number 53 says a shopkeeper buys A shopkeeper buys a certain number of books for rupees 720. If the cost per book was rupees 5 less, the number of books that could be bought for rupees 720 would be 2 more. Taking the original cost of each book to be rupees x, write an equation in x and solve it. Okay. Cost of one book is rupees x and he is spending how much rupees 720 that of initial number of books let us find number of books he is getting initial number of books that will be 720 by x divided by the price of each you get that many books in the beginning then you write new number of books 720 but what is the price now new price is how much is it more or less they say two more no sorry rupees 5 less it was x rupees now it is x minus 5 this many books you will get so which is bigger x minus 5 one is bigger or x is bigger this one then that therefore 42 the difference is given 720 by x minus 5 this is yeah new one is bigger so this minus this one is equal to 2 the difference of the number of books is 2 then you solve it Yes. Not tell me. You got any other? Have you got any other question? What? In auditorium, okay. 44, you see, 44. Number 44. I read question. Question says, in an auditorium, comma seats were arranged in rows and columns. The number of rows was equal to the number of seats in each row. When the number of rows has doubled. And the number of seats in each row was reduced by 10. The total number of seats increased by 300. Find number one, the number of rows in the original arrangement, and number two, the number of seats in the auditorium after rearrangement. Okay. Number of rows and number of columns, when you multiply it, you get the total number. One example, suppose this is one row, two row, three row, four rows. And each row there are 3 students. 3, 3, 3, 3. How many students are there? 3 into 4, 12. So to find the total number of seats, we have to multiply the rows with columns. So let the number of rows be x. Let the number of rows be x. Right? Initial number of seats. Initial number of seats. How many seats will be there? They are saying the number of rows is same as the number of seats it is. Suppose there are 10 rows, then in each row there are 10 seats. The total how many seats are there? 10 into 10. The initial number of seats will be x into x, that is x squared. Let us add new number of seats, that is after rearrangement. Now they are saying the number of rows has doubled, that is now the new number of rows is 2x into. And the number of seats in each row was reduced by 10. That is, number of row seats was x, now it is becoming x minus 10. This is the new number of seats. Let us multiply out this one, we get 2x squared minus 20x. Now, the difference in the number of seats is given 300. The number of seats increased by 300. That is, new arrangement is having more number of seats. This minus this, we write like this. Therefore, according to question, 2x squared minus 20x minus initial one is equal to 300. I think after this you will solve. 2x squared minus 6 will become x squared minus 20x. This 300 is coming this side, equal to 0. Break 300 to get 20. How do you get? 30 and 10. 30 tens are 300 and 30 minus 10 is 20. Let us find those answers. So, x squared minus 30x plus 10x minus 300 equal to 0. X is common, you get x minus 30 plus 10 is common, x minus 30 equal to 0. X minus 30, x plus 10 equal to 0. Therefore, x is coming 30 or x is minus 10. This is not possible. Number of seats cannot be negative. X is 30. Now we answer according to the question. Question says the number of rows is original is initial one. What is the number of rows? Number of rows is taken as x. So this is answer. That means there were 30 rows in the original arrangement. Number 2, the number of seats in the new arrangement. Number of seats means new number of seats. Value is what? 2x squared minus 20x. The value of x is put 30 here and simplify it. That is answer. Yes, borrow. Okay, not ask me something else. Ask me or we start you. Number 43, I'll just give the hint, okay, you will do yourself. Hotel bill for a number of people was rupees 4800. Let the number of people be x. Right, initial bill per head. Initial bill per head will be how much? 4800 divided by x. The new bill per head, let us write that. Money is 4800, but what is happening now? 4 more people came, that is number of people is x plus 4. The new bill per head will be 4800 by x plus 4. Then which is bigger, which is smaller? The difference is given 200 rupees. I think second case is smaller, the first case is bigger. Initial one is bigger. Then subtract this minus this is equal to 200. And then you solve it. Yes? Who was asking this question?